Hi, I'm Ann Hazzard, and I'm one of the authors of this book, Something Happened to My Dad. It's also available in Spanish. Algo le pasó a mi papá. My co-author for this book is Vivian Aponte Rivera. She's on vacation right now in Puerto Rico, where she was born and grew up. So I'll be reading the book on my own to you today. The book was illustrated by Gloria Feliz and published by Magination Press. After we listen to the story, I'll ask you a few questions and we will also go over an art activity that you can do. So let's get started. Carmen's father was a magician. He made sarapes fly. He made rabbits vanish. But one day, Carmen's father vanished. Her mother said he was arrested because he didn't have papers. "We have plenty of paper," Carmen said. "Not the kind Papi needs," Mama replied. "People who weren't born in the U.S. need government papers to live or work here." "Do you have papers, Mama?" "Yes, you and I were born here," said Carmen's mom. "Papi was born in Mexico." "Can we give him ours?" Carmen asked. Her mother wiped away a tear and shook her head. Carmen lay awake, her mind racing. She tried to picture Papi in a detention center. Her mother said that's where they take immigrants without papers. Carmen worried that her dad would get sent back to Mexico. Before school, Carmen's mom said, "Don't tell anyone what's going on. I don't want people to look down on us." In the cafeteria, Carmen didn't say a word. She moved the food around on her plate. "Are you okay?" asked Riley. "I'm just tired," said Carmen. She wondered if Mama was right. Would people really think less of them because Papi didn't have papers? Carmen's abuela cooked tamales for dinner. "Remember the magic trick Papi did for my birthday party?" asked Carmen. "Of course," said her abuela. He turned a peanut butter and jelly sandwich into a tamal. "And then ate it," added Carmen's mom. For the first time in days, Carmen smiled. "How can we get Papi out?" she asked. "We have to convince a judge to allow him to stay in the U.S., said Carmen's abuelo. "We need an immigration lawyer to help us." "But we can't afford one," said her mother. "We can barely pay our bills without money from Papi's job." The next week, Carmen's classmates shared family histories. Riley told about her dad's ancestor who immigrated from Ireland many years ago. Irish people were starving because the potato crop got ruined. Jaden told about his mom's ancestors who were brought here from Africa. They were forced to work as slaves on plantations. Nazar and his family used to live in Syria. His uncle was a doctor who was killed in a war there. "We might have died if we stayed," Nazar said. When it was Carmen's turn, she said that her mother's parents came from Mexico for better paying jobs. She did not mention her father. In the library, Rosa asked her what was wrong. Carmen covered her mouth, but words rushed out anyway. "Papi got arrested because he doesn't have papers. He might get deported back to Mexico. What if I never see him again?" Some kids had been listening, and they told some other kids. A few gave Carmen funny looks, but Nazar said, "My favorite neighbor doesn't have papers." Carmen's mother asked her if anyone knew about Papi. "I told Rosa," admitted Carmen, and some other kids overheard. "Are you mad?" "No, mi amor," said Carmen's mom. "I told a friend who knows a good lawyer, and our church wants to collect money to help us pay." Let's tell Papi, said Carmen. It took hours to drive to the detention center. Carmen curled up in Papi's lap, content as a cat. Mama said, if the church asks for donations, everyone will know our situation. I'm not embarrassed, answered Papi. We've built a beautiful life. Families belong together, said Carmen. People will want to help us. Finally, Carmen met the family's new lawyer. She was thrilled, imagining that the lawyer would quickly free Papi. But 3 months passed, and the family was still apart. At school, Rosa asked about Papi. Carmen sighed. It might be a long time before the judge decides. Lo siento, said Rosa. Riley brought over a sign-up sheet for the spring talent show. Remember last year, she asked? Your dad pulled a flower out of the principal's ear. Carmen was torn. If she entered the contest, more kids might ask why her father wasn't there. But she was tired of just waiting. What would Papi want her to do? Jaden began the talent show with some spectacular karate kicks. Next, Rose's cousins danced with skirts flying high. Carmen paced off stage. Soon there would be nowhere to hide. She imagined Poppy's smile, warm as buttered toast. She took a deep breath, put on her hat, and stepped forward. In the audience, she saw her mother, her grandparents, and some families from church. For her final trick, Carmen linked and unlinked 3 silver rings. These rings are my Papi, Mama, and me, she declared. That last trick was amazing, said Nazar. How did you do it? That's between Papi and me, said Carmen. One secret worth keeping, added her mom. Carmen felt brave, strengthened by memories of Papi and smiles from friends. Boldly waving her wand, she said, magic comes in many forms. So I hope you enjoyed the story. You might have noticed that the last page of the story was a little different than some of the other pages. What did you notice about this last page? You might have noticed that it doesn't really have words that go along with it. And it looks like it's a child's drawing. Who do you think drew it? Maybe Carmen? What do you think it means? It could be what happened next in the story, or it could be what Carmen hopes will happen. We decided to leave it up in the air how the story ends. We did that to make the story realistic, because in many families where a parent is detained, the parent is deported and has to go back to their home country. In some situations, the family is reunited and stays together. But whatever happens, it often takes a long time for the judge and the courts to decide. So we wanted readers of the story to feel some of the same feelings that Carmen might be feeling as she's waiting and waiting to find out what will happen with her family. She's probably feeling sad and worried and frustrated. So maybe you felt some of these feelings too as you listened to the story, and maybe you can understand Carmen's situation a little bit better. Now I want you to look again at the cover of the book, and you might notice that there are some butterflies, monarch butterflies, on the cover of the book. Just like humans, butterflies travel or migrate from place to take care of themselves. So in the fall, monarch butterflies fly from the U.S. down south to Mexico, where the weather is warmer. And in the spring, they fly back from Mexico to the United States, where they lay their eggs for the next generation of butterflies. Because of this, butterflies have become the symbol of immigrant rights. And by that, we mean treating immigrants fairly. So, because butterflies are a symbol of immigrant rights, you might enjoy a craft that is going to be making a puppet that's a butterfly. So you can do this at home. First, you need a popsicle stick. And then you can draw the shape of a butterfly on a piece of paper. And then you can color that shape however you want. Then, to make the antennas, you cut a piece of pipe cleaner, and then you're going to bend it in a V, and then you're going to curl the pieces over to make an antenna, and then you're going to put it all together. You're going to cut out the wings, glue them on the popsicle stick, and you're going to glue the antenna at the top. Let me show you what it'll look like when it's done. Here's one that looks just like a monarch butterfly. You can see that we drew some lines and then colored it orange because that's the usual color of monarch butterflies. And, you know, if you move it, the wings will flap some, just like it's flying. Here's another butterfly that another child did, and she decided just to be creative and use her own idea for designs and colors, and you can do that too. So I hope you enjoy making a butterfly finger puppet, and remember that butterflies are the symbol of immigrant rights, which means treating immigrants fairly and kindly. Thanks.